expert warriors for hire, all seasoned in combat. They won't let you down. You can put a price on the warriors I have for hire, but you can't put a price on the glory they'll win you. I've got sword fighters, mages, archers, all willing to fight by your side if the price is right. Companion you need, I can provide. I have for hire, but you can't put a price on the glory they'll win. Having extra help in a fight. I'll guarantee you that.
The door seems like any door, at least at first. Then you notice it's unblemished wood. There is no knot, no scratch. The wood groans and creaks. The face vanishes. The anguished face appears once more. It dips its forehead towards you and waits. A shudder of pleasure racks the figure in the door. It seems to breathe. All of a sudden, all anguish is gone. It gives you the sternest of looks.
No entry allowed through the starboard stateroom door. Please use the port side door.
Whatever type of companion you need.
I am summoned. Speak the password. Yes, and yes again. The word is spoken. Welcome to the stateroom.
Just one more moment, please.
He clicks together two halves of some type of gauntlet sitting in his lap and turns his full attention to you.
And there. Rescued at last, am I? To whom do I owe my thanks? I'm a prisoner, of course. Do you think I'd be sitting here calmly if I was a Magister holdout? That infernal Dallas woman left me trapped here, too weak to escape. It seems I'm in your debt. Dallas took a particular interest in me and my skills. I'm an expert in healing, crafting, and more arcane practices. She kept me here to do her bidding, until you took her flagship from right under her nose, it seems. I've offered my services for gold in the past, yes. But my labors for Dallas were far from voluntary.
He extends his arm and pushes up the sleeve. Beneath, the skin is withered and discolored, as if it were magically decayed.
She used some form of domination device on me, forcing my hands to do her bidding, and half ruined them in the process. Well, the situation is looking immeasurably better now. You'll hear no more complaints from me. So why don't you tell me all about my valiant rescuers? To whom do I owe my thanks? A wise philosophy. One should always embrace the opportunities that present themselves. I ought to continue what I'm doing here, unless there was anything else. Oh, cast spells, tinker with relics, meddle with the laws of nature. All the sorts of things power-hungry despots love to do. She had me enchanted dead cat over there, so it would seem alive.
He clicks the gauntlet into place around his withered forearm, his eyes on you the whole time.
But that damn contraption that she used on me seems to have fogged my memory. The rest is a blur. No! Necromancy is an unsavory practice, not something to be trifled with lightly. This is but a cunning illusion of my own creation, nothing more.
His face abruptly creases into a smile.
But come now, enough of Dallas and dead cats. You've taken this ship and granted my freedom. This is a happy moment. I'm afraid I cannot tell you what I do not remember. Could you pass me that copper wire just there?
He takes the copper with a nod of gratitude. His sleeve slips back above his elbow. In its crook, you see part of a tattoo, a pattern of concentric circles rendered in black.
Perhaps my memory will come back with time, but for now, I'm afraid there's little more I can add. Dallas didn't tell me anything if she could avoid it, but I did overhear her practicing an ancient lizard dialect. That might ring a bell with you, might it? My thoughts exactly. Curious how Dallas would seek to learn such things, don't you think? Perhaps she left something behind to point to her intentions. Took it? No, no, I made it! Have you seen the kind of metalwork the Magisters deploy? This is in a different class to them! As I said, the Magisters left me weakened, but this will help give me the strength to carry on my work. Despite what she did to me, I can't help but admire the woman a little. She's unwavering. She will break before she bends. If you cross paths with her, be sure to break her. I doubt you will get another chance. I'm doing my utmost to be civil to you, under rather trying circumstances. Why must you push me like this? I'm more than a sum of my parts, friend, indeed. But I fear you might have come to the wrong calculation about me. How about you just let this matter rest?
I'm not perfect myself. It isn't for me to judge this one.
Something tells me that he'll only bring us woe, but I can't judge him, yet.
Anyone who faced enslavement deserves our sympathy, not our blades. Leave him.
He takes your hand in his gauntlet-clad fist and shakes it. There's a lot more power in his grip than his slender frame would suggest.
Call me Tarquin. And consider me at your service. We're barely acquainted. Why should I tell you anything personal? I do not confide in reptilian fops. Whatever measure you have of yourself is no doubt bloated by the labors of slaves. Leave me.
Enter at your leisure.
Junk. Pyramid. What on Revelon is this for?
Only one way to find out. Try using it.
This. Whatever it is, it appears to be written in verse.
I've spotted something.
What use Fortjoy had has been spent. New hunting grounds wait across the sea, so by all means, let us sail. Ha! People will enslave anything these days. At least back in my day, they had the elegance to opt for an elf. Home, there's no such thing. I hail from the land that was, the Kingdom of Fog, the grave of divinity. If ever I had a home, it has long since gone up in the smoke of death fog, along with so many elves. So, no home, except everywhere, really. The world is mine. It's mine because I say it is.
She looks at you expectantly.
Yes. You may bow before the Queen of the World. We, the Queen of the World, smile upon thee with favor. We dub thee Knight of the Needle. Arise, good sir, and wear your title proudly.
She takes you by the hands and laughs heartily as you stand up.
How kind of you to play along. We won't forget.
My prey. My tail rattles like a snake's. I suffer. Don't touch me. My very being's a curse. Was Tarquin that wretch, that rat? I ate an ill mouse and passed in my sleep, and the brooding boar brought me back on a lark. Me miserable. Mumsy? Is she here? Mumsy, where are you? 'Tis I, Booply Bear. I am quite changed, but don't be frightened. There is no shame in being ridiculous in the name of love. You? She sent you?
The cat begins to purr and rub itself on your ankles.
Any friend to Mumsy is a friend to me. I believe the song is around here somewhere. The song, of course. Trouble not my weary mind with dancery.
The cat purrs, an eerie clicking sound.
Tell Mumsy to come back soon. Now that I am but bone, I'm too light to trip the moving door. I'm sure there's a rat back there.
No, Quirkus, don't be like that. I was looking at his bone structure for academic purposes. There's nothing to be jealous of, honestly.
Guards or victims?
Both, I fear.
another pyramid.
Thank you.
speak if you wish to.
Blades won't mark, magic won't maim, and I won't budge.
I found something.
Thank you. You did it. I knew there had to be a way, and you found it.
You got through the door. You really are a god, Woken.
Until the cage is locked again. Hope you find something useful.